Noddy, Noddy, the little man with the red and yellow car. Noddy, Noddy, his tinkling bell means he's the happiest little fellow in all Toyland. There's Biggies and Tubby and Mr. Plod and all his special friends. It's sixpence an adventure and he'll take you home again. Noddy, 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 Noddy.
It was a friendly evening in Toyland. Noddy was enjoying supper with Tessie Bear and Dinah Doll.
Mmm, what delicious apple pie! I wish I had my own apple tree. I'd pick apples and make pies every single day. You could buy an apple tree, Noddy, from Mr. Straw's farm. What a clever idea, Dinah Doll. I'll buy one tomorrow. Oh, I haven't got any spare sixpences. You could earn more sixpences. A lot of toys would like to drive a car like you do, Noddy. You could teach them. If I charged 2 sixpences for every lesson, I'd soon have enough to buy an apple tree.
Yes.
Hello, Noddy. Dinah Doll says you'll give me a driving lesson.
Well, it'll cost 2 sixpences.
Here they are. Vroom, vroom!
Have you ever driven a car, Clockwork Mouse?
Yeah, I was very good. You must teach me to be brilliant.
Do you remember how to drive?
Yeah, of course.
What's this for?
Well, that's the one thing I've forgotten. What does it do?
It tells the car which way to go.
Easy! Watch this!
Slow down before we get to Stony Bridge.
Don't worry.
Well, that was your first lesson.
Oh, thank you, Noddy. I'm a brilliant driver now, so I shan't need any more lessons.
Good. I'll find other toys to teach.
I'm too large to drive a car, Noddy. I expect I put my feet through the floor and I wouldn't see where I was going because my trunk would blow in my eyes.
Never mind, Mr. Jumbo. I'll ask Sammy Sailor. Hello, Sammy. Would you like to drive a car?
Oh, no, young Noddy. Car driving's no for the likes of we seafaring folk. I love to stand on deck struggling with the rigging, the great wooden wheel heaving in my hands, the mighty waves tossing my wee vessel high and low with a salt spray lashing my face.
How interesting, Sammy Sailor, but why are you telling me all this?
I'm sorry, Mr. Jumbo, I thought you were a Noddy.
Ah, yes, we do look rather alike.
Are you sure you don't want to drive a car, Big Ears?
No, thank you, Noddy.
Oh, I'll never make enough sixpences to buy an apple tree.
An apple tree?
Yes, I want to buy an apple tree from Mr. Straw's farm so I can eat my own apples and bake my own pies.
Well, now, I might be able to help you.
Oh! Hello, Clockwork Mouse.
Oh, hello. Yeah, I wish I dared borrow Noddy's car.
You can't drive a car.
Yeah, I can. I'm brilliant. Noddy taught me. He wants to buy an apple tree from Mr. Straw's farm, so he's giving driving lessons to earn lots of sixpences.
Apple trees? Car?
This is a clever scheme growing in my head.
It so happens, my dear Mouse, that we goblins have agreed to take a number of Mr. Straw's apple trees to sell to the toys.
Have we?
Of course we have. All we need is a car to collect them in and someone to drive it brilliant. We'll share the sixpences we make with that brilliant driver. Do you know a brilliant driver, Clockwork Mouse?
Me, me, me. I'll be your brilliant driver.
Well, I never thought of that. All we need now is a car.
Well, let's borrow Noddy's car. He's not using it.
What a clever little mouse you are.
just the thing for Noddy.
My car! It's gone!
Hello, young Noddy. And why are you talking to yourself?
I left my car here, but someone's taken it.
One step at a time, Noddy. Step one, examine evidence. Nope. No sign of your car.
We've got to find it.
No, Noddy, that's step three. Step two is looking for clues.
When do I have my sixpences?
You're having no sixpences. Get off with you.
That's not fair. Hey, hey, you, come back.
Our first customer.
Mr. Sparks, would you like to buy a brand new apple tree? It's only 4 sixpences.
An apple tree? Oh, now that would make a fine gift for Miss Pink Cat. Noddy's car.
Come back! Yes, your whole car. So glad it's stopped.
Whatever is going on?
The goblins, they found out I was a brilliant driver. They made me take them to the farm to fetch lots of apple trees so they could sell them for lots of sixpences.
Come along, Clockwork Mouse. Tell your story to PC Plod.
We haven't found any clues, Mr. Plod. Can we do step three now and find my car?
First, we must do step two in a bit. Asking questions. Mr. Plod, Clockwork Mouse has something to say.
The goblins, yeah, they made me take Noddy's car.
Ha-ha!
They made me drive them to Mr. Strawsy's farm so they could take lots of apple trees and sell them.
Oh, Miss Pink Cat, I've brought you a gift. An apple tree.
Oh, dear, Mr. Sparks. Oh.
I'll take charge of that.
Really?
Did you purchase this tree from Gobbo and Sly, Mr. Sparks?
Well, yes.
They had no right to sell said tree. So I shall proceed to step four, making an arrest.
I'll drive you to the station.
Is my car all right, Big Ears?
It's fine, Noddy. Kindly take us to your house. I have something special for you.
Thank you.
This is a perfect spot, Noddy. Plant the apple in the hole, and soon you'll have your own tree.
How long must I wait?
You may see something when you wake tomorrow morning.
Big Ears must have given me a magic apple. Oh my, what a lot of apples. Let's taste them. There. Hello, Noddy. Big Ears told us to visit you. He gave me a magic apple, Tessie. It's already grown into a tree. Oh, I thought I'd pick these two. We'll eat apples all day.
Oh, better not, Noddy. You'll get tummy ache.
Oh, I'll take care, Mrs. Tubby. But whenever we want, we can make delicious apple pie. Yummy.
Noddy. Noddy. The little man with the red and yellow car. Noddy.
Noddy.
His tinkling bell means he's the happiest little fellow in all Toyland. There's Big Ears and Tubby and Mr. Plod and all his special friends. It's sixpence an adventure and he'll take you home again. And now it's time for Noddy to wave and say goodbye. He's tired and sleepy and nodding his head. He's ready to curl himself up in bed and see what tomorrow brings. For Noddy, Noddy, Noddy. Noddy.